Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this is a very, an amazing man. He is, as you know, right?
Thank you.
Right? Speaker of the House of Indonesia. He's here to see me. Setya Novanto, one of the most powerful men and a great man, and his whole group is here to see me today, and we will do great things for the United States. Is that correct?
Yes.
Do they like me in Indonesia?
Yes, I like. Thank you very much.
Speaker of the House in Indonesia. Thank you very much. Thank you.
And they say it's going to be a big, exciting announcement. Donald Trump would, in fact, sign that pledge.
The best way for the Republicans to win is if I win the nomination and go directly against whoever they happen to put up. And for that reason, I have signed the pledge.
I have signed the pledge. So this was this big celebratory moment for candidate Trump and for the Republican Party. All right, for the party, it's a load off their mind because they won't face an independent spoiler candidacy from Trump when he inevitably loses the primary. For Trump, he clearly relishes being in the driver's seat like that, getting all this attention for this big decision and having the crowd turn out and hyping all the excitement of the moment. He turned it into this big Trump Tower event. But it was weird. At the end of that event, amid all the excitement of this big hyped moment, Trump decided to do something sort of inexplicable, just something that struck everybody as a little weird.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this is a very, an amazing man. He is, as you know, right? Right. Speaker of the House of Indonesia. He's here to see me. Setya Novanto, one of the most powerful men and a great man. And his whole group is here to see me today. And we will do great things for the United States. Is that correct?
Yes.
Do they like me in Indonesia?
Yes, I like. Thank you very much.
Speaker of the House in Indonesia. Thank you very much.
Do they like me in Indonesia? Yes, I like you. I like. As you know, everybody, this, of course, is, what's your title? This is sort of a weird moment. The thing was over. He says goodbye to everybody. He walks away and everybody starts to, you know, break down. And well, the reporters there are going to go like report to camera about what's going on. And then he starts the whole event again. This weird tacked on coda to the signing the loyalty pledge event. It was just a strange moment in the moment. It did solve the mystery of who that guy was, who looked a little confused to be in the middle of the big loyalty pledge announcement. He was standing right behind Trump while Trump was doing this thing and holding up the pledge. This probably made no sense for somebody who hadn't been following every twist and turn in the Republican presidential primary this year. But it turns out that guy standing behind Trump looking confused while he made that announcement was the Indonesian Speaker of the House. Just an unusual cameo for that man in the middle of our presidential politics. Now, we have talked about that weird moment a couple of times on this show before because it was so strange. From what we can figure out, we think the reason the Indonesian Speaker of the House was there in Trump Tower that day is because of a business meeting. We think the Indonesian House Speaker was there not to talk to Trump about running for president. We think he was there to talk to him about Donald Trump business interests in Indonesia. Well, today, that same man from that weird cameo in the Republican presidential primary, former Indonesian Speaker of the House, Setya Novanto, today he was sentenced to 15 years in prison in the biggest corruption bust in modern Indonesian history. Quote, Novanto was convicted of masterminding the theft of more than $170 million from a national identity card program. The New York Times calling this today one of the most high-profile convictions in the history of this graft-plagued nation. The conviction and this expected 15-year prison term represents the downfall of one of Indonesia's most powerful men and the climax of a long public corruption saga involving this particular guy. As the Times puts it today, Setya had been, quote, implicated in a number of corruption scandals over the years, but he had seemed untouchable. He had seemed untouchable, past tense. Now he's been touched. Now he's going to the pokey for 15 years. So that groundbreaking prison sentence today is important for Indonesia. Also turns out to be a nice sort of coda to the coda of that moment, a sort of final epilogue for what was that all about. I mean, in that moment, if we'd all had better foresight at the time, we might have recognized that that moment with Setya Novanto would be a tone-setting moment for the Trump administration, right? For a recurring problem in the Trump presidency. I mean, if you think about what Trump was doing there, what was Trump doing in that moment in the Trump Tower lobby, right? He was doing something weird. An event was stopped and over, and he restarted it to do this thing. Restarted it to brag about the powerful nature of this man who had come to see him on a business matter. But he also sort of randomly and without need to, he went out of his way to give his own Donald Trump public endorsement to this man in front of the assembled National Press Corps. I mean, it seems clear from the way he handled that moment, he didn't even know the guy's name. You can see him reading the guy's name off a note card when he makes this announcement. Even reading it off the note card, he still gets the guy's name wrong. I mean, in such a circumstance, why would you call that person a great man, as he did? He said, this is a great man. Why would you give that kind of endorsement when you don't even know the guy's name well enough to read it correctly off a piece of paper? Why make that sort of public endorsement when you apparently really have no idea about even the very basic background of this famously corrupt person who's standing beside you?
Indonesia's Speaker of Parliament and Trump sympathizer, who was arrested last week over his alleged role in a $170 million graft case, has sent a letter from his cell to House leaders pleading to be allowed to keep his job while he fights the charges. Setya Novanto, who has denied wrongdoing, is being held for 20 days for questioning by Indonesia's Corruption Eradication Commission KPK. He made the request in a letter handwritten in his holding cell that was released to the media late on Tuesday. The KPK is investigating state losses of about $170 million after allegations that sums ranging from $5,000 to $5.5 million, generated by marking up procurement costs for national electronic cards, were divided up among politicians in Parliament. I ask other Parliament leaders to give me an opportunity to prove that I wasn't involved, Novanto wrote. And in the meantime, do not organize an Ethics Council plenary session on the possibility of making me non-active, either as Parliament Speaker or as a Member of Parliament. Novanto, also chairman of Golkar, Indonesia's second largest party and a partner in the ruling coalition, is one of the most senior politicians to be detained by the KPK, which is popular among Indonesians for targeting members of the establishment suspected of abuse of power. His battle with the graft agency has gripped Indonesia, where newspapers have splashed the story on front pages and memes mocking him have circulated on social media. He has clung to power through several previous corruption cases and repeatedly missed summonses for questioning by the agency in recent months, saying he needed heart surgery. Novanto was named a suspect on November 10 again after using a controversial legal maneuver to get earlier charges dropped last month. In another letter, addressed to Golkar, Novanto said there has been no discussion of me temporarily or permanently stopping as chairman of Golkar. In that letter, he nominated Idris Merham to serve as acting chairman of the party. Novanto's lawyer, Frederick Unati, told Reuters it was up to parliament and party officials to decide if he should keep his posts, but he was confident that his client would win his case. Unati said, "We have strong proof, and in every court we always win." Asked if he was concerned about the strength of evidence against Novanto, KPK spokesman Fabri Dianzia said, "From the beginning the KPK has had strong evidence, and the two people we have put on trial already in this case have been found guilty even up to an appeal stage."
This is the largest majority Muslim country, and President Widodo, as he often says, and as I often quote him as saying, says Indonesia is proof that Islam, democracy, and moderation are compatible. He is the leader of a vast democracy. A quarter of a billion Muslims live in Indonesia, and it is a nation where democracy, Islam is the religion of the majority of its people, and moderation or tolerance, mutual respect, operate hand in hand. And that's it's a great example to the world. Islam is practiced by about a quarter of the world's population. And in this country we see, a country with whom we are building closer ties, we see that democracy, Islam, moderation, tolerance are compatible. The vast majority of Australian Muslims are patriotic, hardworking, seeking to get ahead, committed to peacefully living in Australia and abiding by our laws. And I might say that in the war against terror, and it is a war that we are waging in the Middle East and around the world, in that war against Islamist terrorism, extremism, our best allies, our most important allies, Muslim leaders like Joko Widodo, the millions and billions of Muslims who are thoroughly committed to peace